Hello guys, welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to make this interior scene. We're going to lay out the scene in SketchUp, and then import it in Blender to set up the material, lighting, camera, and render it out. So let's jump right into it. First thing first, we're going to find reference. I usually use Pinterest. So we can go ahead and find interior scene inspiration. And then, if you find some design that you like, you can save it to your board. Here is my interior inspiration board. For the interior scene that we're going to make, I'm using this picture as the main reference. After finding some reference, we can go ahead to SketchUp. Make the floor and the wall first. I make the floor with the size of 4x4 meters, and the wall with 3 meter height. And then I'm going to open up 3D warehouse, where you can find 3D asset for free. Here I'm looking for couch, table, interior plans, magazine, etc. I download them separately, so I have individual file for each asset. Then you can go ahead and import the 3D file, and try to arrange the layout. I'm using the reference image as inspiration. I also scale some object to make it fit nicely into the scene. Make sure to keep the scale proportional. Like here, I'm scaling the table so it has the same height as the couch. After some time arranging the layout, here are the results. Finally, you can make the ceiling and the wall on the left and right side with some openings, so that light can come through. Make sure to save it as SketchUp file, and layouting process in SketchUp is done. Now we're in Blender. First, let me just delete this cube and the light. And you need to first install the SketchUp Importer add-on. The download link is in the description. So after you download it, you can install it via Edit, Preference, Add-on, and Install Add-on. And then you can go and select the zip file. After that, you can import the scene via File, Import SketchUp Scene. And then choose the SketchUp file. Now, as you can see, I import the SketchUp scene to Blender. And after that, I want to set up the camera. So go into the preferred view and then press Ctrl+Alt+0 to get the camera into the preferred view. And you can move the camera by pressing G along with the axis, like X, Y, or Z. And then I change the camera resolution to 2000x2000 pixel. And change the focal length of the camera as well on object data properties. Maybe I want to set this wall further back so it doesn't block the camera and give more space to the walls on the side as well. And then I adjust the camera a little bit more to find the best view. You can also rotate the camera by pressing R along with the axis. I also arranged the layout of the room to get the best view in camera. Okay, now I think the camera setup is done. Don't forget to save the Blender file. Now, we can go into material setup. As you can see here, the material from the SketchUp file is also imported to Blender. But for the floor and the wall, I want to use PBR material. So, what is PBR material? PBR material, or physically based rendering material, is a virtual material that can simulate physical characteristics of a material in real world, thus creates a realistic result. For this material, you can browse and download it for free on cgbookcase.com, ambientcg.com, and many others. Now, I want to set up the material for the floor. So select the wall and the floor object, go to the edit mode, and select only the floor surface, and select P to separate it by selection. Then we can select only the floor, isolate it by pressing slash, and then select all these faces and press F to change it into one singular face. Now I want to add a new material and call it wood floor. And open the window on the right side, go to the shader editor, before import the texture, make sure you already installed Node Wrangler add-on. It's useful to help you work with nodes efficiently. So select the principal PSDF, press Ctrl Shift T, and then select the wood floor. Here, I want to select the color, the normal GL, and the roughness, because I usually only use these three maps. Click Principal Texture Setup, and then all these maps already set up for you instantly. Now we go into material preview, and we need to go to edit mode, select the face, and press assign. Now as you can see, the material is changing, but it's not looking like a wood texture yet. So go into edit mode and press U and unwrap. Now you can see the texture. Now I'm going to show you what each texture does. First, the base color. It provides the base texture of the material. For example, the wood texture. The next one is roughness map. It provides the reflectivity information of the material. You can control it by adding color ramp. The more contrast it gets, the more reflective the surface will be. And the last one is the normal map. This map will add details to the flat surface. And then, you can control the strength of the detail. Combine these three maps to get realistic material. Maybe I'll tone down the reflectivity a little bit. Then press slash again to return to the normal view. And the floor texture is done. Now, for the walls, we're going to use the default material and rename it to walls. For this material, I want to use the base color from principled BSDF. But for the details, I want to use normal map from the PBR wall material that I have downloaded. So add image texture and normal map node. Plug it to the color input. Make sure you select the image texture and then press Ctrl T to get the mapping and texture coordinate node. And plug this to the normal input. While the wall selected, don't forget to go to edit mode, select all the faces, and press U and click unwrap. Now click open here and find the normal map from the PBR wall material. Now as you can see, it's too strong, so maybe make it smaller, like so. Now that's better, and maybe reduce the strength. Then I want to change the color to dark blue. Also, don't forget to set the color space of the normal map to non-color to make it work properly. Now the texture for the wall and the floor is done. And for the other material, because they already have the material from the SketchUp file, I'm basically just using it and adjust the roughness. You can see it on the preview. The roughness will control the reflectivity of the material. As for this wood-like texture, because it's from steel, I want to make it metallic. So I bump up the metallic value to 1 and then control the roughness. And for the couch, make sure you click use node, rename it to couch, and I want to change it to light blue color, like so. And then basically do the similar thing to other material. Here I want to continue to set up the wall material, because I think the texture is still a little bit too big. Maybe 10 scale, or maybe 11. And you can also rotate the texture. Maybe this one set to 90. Like so, and set the strength to 1.5. As for the ceiling, we need to turn it maybe just into white, so the light will bounce more from the ceiling later on. Add new material and make sure you select the ceiling. go into edit mode, press A to select all the face, and press assign, like so. So now, all the material setup is done. Now for the lighting, I want to use the world lighting. You can go ahead and go to the world properties. By default, it's set to background. And if you go to rendered view, there's no lighting yet. So change the color from gray to white. And then maybe the bump up the strength to 4.4. Now, as you can see, the lighting comes through these two openings. You can also control how much the light came in by adjusting the size of this opening. Here I want to the lighting from the right side is much bigger than on the left side, like so. And then we go to render properties. For the viewport, I set it to 100 so it doesn't get too heavy. For the render, maybe I'll set it to 300. You can go for the higher number like 500 or maybe 1000, but I will just do a quick render for this time. Make sure you also check the noise button. And for the film tab, bump up the exposure. Maybe 1.4, 1.3. So the exposure of the camera is also get brighter. Okay. Make sure you're on cycles, and then you can go ahead and hit the render button by pressing F12. Now the tutorial is done. I hope you guys find this video useful. Make sure to hit like and subscribe button, and see you guys in other videos.